Welcome back. Still Breakfast Central on News Central. It's a Monday. Well, if you just joined us, it's quite a bit, but perhaps just in time for some interior designs this Monday morning. Now, nowadays, with people willing to invest more time and effort in personalising and getting the most out of the personal spaces they inhabit, be it an office, studio, home, or perhaps in a studio like this one right here, the need for new and emerging interior designs to make a distinct presence is felt really on the rise. Now, today, we're joined by an emerging interior designer, Tega Atata, of Interiors with Tega. Yes. Morning. Welcome to Breakfast Central.
Thank you.
Right. Personal living space, office space, reading space, and what have not, you know, seems to be on the rise when it comes to living spaces in Africa and indeed like Lagos, Nigeria. Well, tell us about your business, first of all, Interiors with Tega.
Okay. So Interiors with Tega is interior design firm, which specializes in space management from renovations to finishing.
Okay.
Yeah, so we engage in from flooring, POP, you know, furniture making.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so a full
gamut.
Package, yes.
Wow. And this is some of your works
that
we're, you know, we're seeing right here. Down to the furniture.
Yes,
to down the furniture. To the upholstery.
Yes.
Okay, and flooring?
Yes, flooring.
Okay, and picture scale and all that. Wow, so it's quite a lot. So interior design takes in everything, you know, it takes in all the art of craft and of homemaking, and not just for home, but also for offices. Well, how would you describe, when did this all start for you, first of all, Interiors with Tega?
Officially, it's like, let's say, 6 months.
Okay.
Yeah, but unofficially, it's been like a year.
Okay.
Yeah, so started when I study electrical engineering.
Okay.
So I do electrical supplies and all. So when I get to clients' place, they ask me, do you have anybody that wants to, you know, that knows how to do interior? These questions keep popping up. And right from when I was young, I like, you know, rearranging my mommy's space, my mommy's shop and everything. So I said, okay, I think it's something like, so I went on YouTube.
Okay.
And that's how I started.
And turned it into a business. So you're not just supplying the wiring and and the pipes and the cords and the layers. It's going into the interior. So how would you describe, you know, your personal taste and what really influences it?
Well, for me, my taste is, I actually created a niche for myself when it comes to interior design space, because most of the designs I've been seeing are mostly contemporary, you know, and all that. So, but I said, I want to do something totally different from the Nigerian, you know, interior design. So I, you know, started researching about the interiors abroad. So that's how it all started. So I had to learn things from YouTube and all videos and stuff.
Do you have to pick up a hammer and a nail?
Yeah. So when I had to like create this thing that when you see my work, you know, this job is done by this person.
Interiors with Tega.
So it's totally a different kind of interior.
So how would you say in terms of the acceptance of the market and the clientele, is it really home based for Interiors with Tega or more office based clientele?
Well, hopefully I get to, you know, expand, because, you know, Nigeria, once they know you for this particular thing, it's hard for them to, like, you know, switch, you know. So for now, it's basically residential. But I have, like, few office projects coming up.
Okay.
I'd like to show.
All right. What about any inspirations from other designers, Africa? None?
No.
All right, but interior design is becoming quite a big market. Do you think you're going to be, you know, in terms of the competition, you see yourself as a lone wolf and lone wolf playing in this whole game?
I'm not a lone wolf playing in this game.
Yes,
I'm here to stay.
How competitive has it been?
Well, for competition, I don't see all that interior designers as my competitors. I see the everyday people as my competitors, because anybody that rents an apartment or builds an apartment want to, you know, go shop their furniture themselves. So it's basically the users that are the competitors, not the interior designers.
All right. Then walk us through your designing process. You know, where does it come? Is it mood wise, or is it based on just the client's preferences?
It's not always about the client's preferences.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
We have like an agreement. We compromise at some point. The client gets to compromise and, you know, accept my idea and refuse it, and at the end of the day, that's how it work.
So is it more of the aesthetics?
Yeah.
And the but you take care of the elaborate detailing?
Yes, I do.
All right. So what do you think perhaps we need more in terms of interior design? Do you think there's any gaps, you know, within Nigeria, Africa space that you've noticed that you think that should be filled?
Yes.
So far, so good?
So far, so good. For the issue, I think the issue is with the landlords or the architects.
Okay.
Yeah, because you walk into a space and you see the flooring multicolored first, then you see the AC unit where they'll mount it on the windows, which is not right. So I have to bring my technician to move the AC to the to a better location because I have to hang my curtains from top to down. So these are the issues that we get to face.
The challenges.
It's really a huge challenge. So I want those people to, like, you know, check this.
Yeah, but being a woman in business, what's your take? How's it been?
I don't think it has anything to do with gender. Yeah, so if you're good at what you do, be it a man or a woman, then people would.
Yeah, so what can we expect from interiors with Tega? You know, this is 2020 and going forward?
Going forward, I want to, you know, work more with architects.
Okay.
Yes, and, you know, infuse my ideas into their processing, because it's easier to
go
do that,
from scratch. Yeah.
So at the end of the day, everything comes out well.
Rather than coming to the finished project.
Coming after, yes, and you start breaking and redoing, renovating. Right. That's what most interior designers go through. You get to break and rebuild.
Somebody's house and somebody's office space.
Yes.
Good luck with you with that. And perhaps keep the nails and the hammers and the chisels not too far. But thank you so much, Tega, from Interiors with Tega, for coming on the show today. It's been such a pleasure indeed. And good luck.
Thank you. Yeah.
Well, if you enjoyed watching this video, click here to get more of it. And don't forget to click here to subscribe.